Then, of course, other kind of thing is retaining walls, we mentioned just now, then foundations, and then stabilizing means improving the ground for other structures. So, one is we mentioned it is possible for us to construct using strong geotextiles or geogrids of the right kind. Today, we have been building up to 45 meter near vertical walls. Now, can you think of a retaining wall, non-retaining wall 40 meter high? What is the base width of that? At least 0.6 h. So, itna jagah chahiye. Itna jagah kahan pe duniya mein? India mein to nahi hai. So, these hardly require a foundation. That is the most surprising part of it now. Okay. So, main thing is that we can build up to 40 meters, but usually 50 meters and the other gimmicks which we do. But beyond that now, we can also think of slopes. Slopes up to 90 meter high. You can't think of a wall for 90 meter height, this one. So, people have done it, we have done in the country. Two such instances, one was done in Vijayawada near Durgagudi, another one is done for the airport in Sikkim, Pongkeng Airport, they have done this. Probably limited height, they have also done for the recently inaugurated airport, Kannur in Kerala. Okay, so then when you are considering embankment, high embankments on soft soils. So, I have shown in the morning, those days the Babylonians have used a bamboo mattress. Obviously, we can use also bamboo mattress, but its life we don't know. I don't think we have the quality of bamboo which was there earlier also due to many reasons. But then we can put layers of this. This is called basal reinforcement. It can be multiple layers of the reinforcement. It can be a special kind of geosynthetic cell also separately built actually in the field. We will talk more of this when the subject comes. Lot of work is done by us in the country, wherein we use such kind of things on black cotton soils of 20 meter thickness also. You can't think of any such wall, any such embankments constructed safely on such kind of soils actually. This allows us to do this. In fact, talking of the payment center, remember that people have fought wars also actually. In the first publication published by the Tensar company, which is called Geogrids and Engineering, Civil Engineering, you know, there is an island called Falklands, you know, British occupied throughout the world. So, one such occupation was a territory called Falklands. So, they had only one airstrip. They couldn't win the war with the local people. It's a small country, very small country, not very rich also, but they couldn't win the war. Why? They were blasting the pavement. So, that's it. The aircraft can't land now. So, these people actually, after bombing now, naturally, if you want to repair, you can repair it anyway. But repairing really means any polymer concrete or either concrete now to put it back into condition. But the moment they place this kind of material, overnight they could again land, of course, win the war. So, there are many situations. In fact, you may not know that some country occupied Kuwait. I don't know whether people know it. About 20 years back, Kuwait was occupied by some other Arab country. Landing from the sea, that means from the ship to the beaches, was possible only because geogrids, because the tanks and all could move over the beach. So, it becomes a very important strategic material also. In fact, it able to take care of the blast loads, it is able to take care of the seismic loads. So, we find that the applications what we are going to touch upon only are peripheral. There are many things which are possible because the nature of the structure which you can build with this, the flexibility with which you can build it. You don't take concrete there, you can take this metal which is light, you can take it to forest, you can take it to jungle. You can cross over rivers, you can cross over anything else because very light, we can carry by, if not backpack, slightly better than that. So, that is one such situation here now. Stabilization means reinforcing. Another case also, for example, I want to lay a road now on a soft soil. Naturally, I can stabilize it by using lime and flash and things like that. I can also do that by using this as a temporary measure or permanent measure. Why I am talking of this is that I don't know how many of you really seen the strategic movement of army. When I was studying actually in Rajasthan, I was also able to see that military trucks actually how to go in sand. Have you seen such kind of movement in desert area? Because the trucks will sink. So, they have actually heavy metal plates, very heavy metal plates, 3-4 inch thick. And so, the army people actually will put these plates, one the other one now, the truck will go by one truck and then they will take out this and put it in front. Well, we should see the fellows, you know, how heavy this, how they are carrying it. Now, you just lay this. The vehicle will move, So the life has become easier actually, and that is the kind of strength we are talking of. So then of course, other kind of thing, water is an enemy for all of us in geological engineering. It also gives us food actually, because structures are not safe against water seepage. So we can create drainage systems, we can create coastal erosion control systems, we can actually ensure that reservoirs are containing the water, and also dams and canals. Applications are again drainage below the basements now, drainage below the pavements, and you can think of roofing also, we can think of astroturfing for all playgrounds now. So you think of this wherever we do not want water now, we want to drain it off easily. We are providing a layer for drainage now perpetually. Okay, we are not bothered about further rain or further is a water table. It will take away the water either from the roof or from the ground, whatever it is now. And another important thing is called fin drain. If this is a wall, if you imagine now, you see there is a fin drain. That means it is a composite which is held with it, because composite allows us to carry more water also. So this water is not allowed to come into the structure. It will be taken care of by a pipe which is along this. So that means, as I said, the pipe is equally important now. Just for the rain, where the water is going to go? It would lead the water somewhere else. So that becomes a geopipe. And because it's coming like a fin actually, like fin of a this one, so it's called fin drain basically. So you think of horizontal drainage, or think of vertical drainage, applications are almost infinite actually. So shuttering, sports fields I mentioned, gas and water storage, pressure lift mats, underground parking, tunnel drainage, you know, I told you about membrane for tunnel lining, but behind that, to carry the water which comes from the ground, now we need thick. If you see the Benahal tunnel actually, they have used a very heavy membrane, maybe 2.5-3 mm thickness. Now behind that is a geotextile of, I think, 1000 or 500 grams per square meter, very heavy geotextile there now. So whatever what is coming from the hills actually is being carried along that and then carried along the pallet of the track now. So that is the importance of that. Naturally, that means every tunnel, in fact, in today's world has got this geo membrane as a liner, and then behind that is always a very thick, heavy geotextile. Then, of course, drainage of leachate is very important in landfills now. So you find that application of drainage itself is so heavy actually. It's not only reinforcement, because you know, when once you're taking out water now, half the problems in geological engineering are solved actually. Best way is to be able to design that. So another way to design it is, when I was a student of engineering, we always thought that water is an enemy to all pavements. One is that our road pavements are constructed along the ground level. So particularly along farms now. What is happening now? Water table is probably higher than the road surface also. So this water enters subgrade and all things is going to ruin that. So there are always drains parallel to that, underground drains. Otherwise, our people always have a so-called trench or VV kind of thing. So they will be buried in the first monsoon. So uska koi fayda hota nahi hai. So these actually are drains which are on either side of the road. So instead of normally having a drain now, you have a trench of any shape you want. The geotextile which is laid like this, and then if the water flow is likely to be heavy, you also put a perforated pipe and fill this with the gravel kind of thing. You close it appropriately, and then what is going to happen now? This geotextile is there all around the dotted one now. What is the function of the geotextile now? So our friend says it is for drain. I said it is a trench drain. I didn't say geotextile is a drain. It is a trench drain. It is carrying water along its plane. All this gravel, everything else is meant to allow water to flow. But if I am not providing the geotextile, what is happening now? The soil is going to come inside this. There is no filter. I create a filter now. So it is going to perform filtration. It is allowing drainage to occur by performing filtration function. Mind you this. Okay, water also can carry it along the plane. But after it is gravel only, there is so much voids there. Why should it get into small void situation now? If gravel is not there, supposing you are providing the sheet drain only, yes, it is possible. Isn't it? So this we have to remember always. Every time we are going to place a geosynthetic now, we ought to know what is it we are placing, why we are placing. Because the why of it means you are going to design for that now. So we come to another level of understanding this now. This is the way in which we think of drainage now. Here the drainage is for essentially for subgrade. I can also put this into the base course. Then it will become another kind of drain. So placement of the drainage, thickness and its dimensions, and the kind of geotextile I am going to use depends upon local conditions. What is the rainfall? What is the water table now? It is near pond or something like that. So that is a design parameter now. So design is by function. It is not by that, oh, all roads in India, we are going to trench drain and say 250 JSM, we are going to provide. No. Half of them may fail also. And mind you, simple thing which you are going to think of it is, for example, if you just go back now, supposing I am trying to show this dotted line as a separate from this. Supposing there is a gap, I mean, it is like a folded kind of thing. Is it going to function like a drain? Is it going to function like a filter? No. It should be perfect contact. If the soil is getting slowed onto this now, it's not going to function. So it should be placed in a given condition. So that means the placement condition is equally important as the design. Remember this. So when we are talking of the opening size, actually, also we define what the opening size depending upon the soil which is there adjacent. So we can say that a geotextile can be mandatory. But we can't say the given geodesic is mandatory. We can't say 250 GSM is mandatory throughout the country. It is also a design. The opening size is defined, distance is defined, the carrying capacity is defined, everything is defined actually. So that is what we have to remember now. So then of course, drainage is important also for walls. You know, we have weep holes, but 90% of them don't work. We are doing a lot of work for Vidarbha actually. We find that sometimes water is flowing too much onto that, sometimes they are completely choked. Koi fayda to hai nahi uska to. Because there is nothing behind that, you know, it is a hole in the concrete now. So, soil will start completely plugging that now. So, here the situation now, which you can use usually to lower the phreatic line. What is the advantage of lowering the phreatic line now? What did you get? Why did you show this phreatic line here now? I could have just shown the pipe. What is the pressure for which you are designing this wall? Earth pressure. Active earth pressure. Okay? If I am not provided this now, I know the drainage now, what is going to happen now? Whatever is going to be up to this. So then what I do now? I design this wall for the so-called earth pressure coefficient plus hydrostatic pressure of equivalent to 1. So the coefficient will become now 1 plus 0.3, let us say it's 30 degrees or 0.33. So, if I am providing this pipe or whatever it is now, I have to not bother about the hydrostatic pressure now, I can design. That means all CBIP pressures, anything else you think of hydraulically, we can take care of that now. Even normal water also, I can take care of by providing a drain along this, a drainage way it is called actually. And people are not using that, so the failure of the structures keep coming in now. So, unless you know how to design a wall, unless you know the importance of this providing drainage or weep holes or drainage bay, naturally you can't replace those things by a geosynthetic now. Because somebody may say, bhai, sasta mil raha hai geogrid, I will put geogrid. It is only a water carrying capacity. Why water carrying capacity is important now? It is showing a pipe actually, schematically. Is it a closer pipe? It is not a closer pipe, it is a perforated pipe obviously, is it not? So then again the same thing will happen. The soil will actually get into this pipe and then choke that pipe also, isn't it? Then what I should do? I will cover with the non-oven geotextile. What is happening when it is hot? You put a cover. Now it is cold, so I put a jam, whatever it is. So like this now. So the moment I find that there is a problem, I am solving it by function. Function of the pipe is to carry water, but water has to get into this. So naturally I put perforations. And then we said it may get choked, so I am putting a geotextile over there. So that is what we call a system, not provision of a pipe. See, we are doing the same thing, but with something in mind. Then what kind of geotextile now? That depends upon the soil conditions there. That depends upon hydraulic gradient which is supposed to take care of. So based upon that, I design this. What all I have to know will be only the gradient distribution actually. Okay, so you see this. The design is always by the function we are respecting. Function is one of the five things we mentioned: separation, drainage, all those things.